I know of him as Officer Brown through the kids in the community. I actually heard of him, good stories from the boys, before I even actually met him.
People come and ask him who he is. You know, they're like, hey, I've heard about you. Who are you?
He's passionate about each and everything he do. But the thing about passion is that it can look good, it can feel good, but without commitment, it's just words.
You know, we love the kids here, and there's not a consistency. They don't see family, they don't see relationships, they don't see people like him who have kind of made it out, because they only see adults who are in jail or who have gotten out and been incarcerated and stuff like that. And so he was making just a different image for these kids to see.
He's investing and sowing his time back into these kids, to the boys. He's stepping up for fathers that are absent, even fathers that are there and maybe not have enough time to spend with their boys.
They're so heavily impacted. When he comes to the door, they rush to him.
They always have somebody they know that's in their corner, always have somebody that they can go back to that's pushing them forward and helping them to become their best selves.
These kids are our future, so we have to take them and teach them and invest in them so they can make, you know, our futures better.
I don't know anybody who tries his best and there's always a yes to him. No matter how much stuff is on the schedule, no matter how busy he is, he makes room.
God, we come to you saying thank you. We come to you saying thank you for this day, God, and thank you for this opportunity. For God, you have been so, so good to us. God, you've been faithful. You've been kind. You've been awesome to us, and God, and we thank you for selecting us as your children and calling us to do your work. God, we thank you for this day, and we thank you that you just come and empower us to do what you call us to do. I do a lot of stuff for administration too, so you'll see all that. You also get to meet other security guards and police officers too.
People looked at me and said, "You will never become anything." I grew up in Waco, Texas. I attended Waco ISD my whole life. My mom was a single parent. My dad did live out of town, and I did get to go to his house on the weekends sometimes. But I feel like I missed out on a lot of things that I needed from positive role models.
9812, I'm 10:41 at 8 o'clock. I'll be en route to Waco High for traffic enforcement.
We lived in a low-income household, so sometimes my mom had a job and sometimes she didn't. I remember my mom not being able to pay bills, not being able to pay rent. And I also remember times where we had good times. When I was in elementary school, I remember my family being deeply hurt by my uncle being murdered on Waco Drive. I didn't really know him well, but I remember the pain of my family. My teacher asked me, what am I gonna do when I grow up? And I told her that I'm gonna be a police officer. I'm gonna help families find justice. I wanted to make a difference. I wanted to be the one in my family to say, hey, you know what? I'm not gonna be the one committing crime. I'm gonna be the one who's standing for what's right.
Good
morning. What's going on? You wanna go do a walk and talk with me? Okay, I'm gonna walk with him. Come on. You're gonna be all right. We're not gonna end today tough, okay? You haven't upset. You need to just calm down. You started out upset, but this is what we can do. Take a breather. I want you to have a good day today. I want you to have a good day today. I don't want you getting in trouble.
Principals and teachers love that I actually take the time out with each student. If there's a student that needs help, they know they can call Officer Brown and I'm gonna go help them. I will pull them out of class. I will talk to them. We will spend lunch together. I'm gonna go beyond my normal duties to make sure these kids succeed, because these kids are our future. Because a lot of times kids just need to know that someone is watching me. Someone cares enough.
I think even when I was in high school, I needed someone to come to me and tell me, get it together every now and then. So I enjoy doing that. I don't have to walk around and help with behavior issues and talking in class and all that. But if I can motivate a kid, why not, you know?
I believe in the process of mentorship. My pastor discipled me for many, many years. It taught me discipline. It taught me service. It taught me hard work. It taught me how to become a strong man of God. So I know the end result because I'm a product of it. A lot of people don't understand, like, why do you invest so much in these kids? They're never gonna learn. But I was one of those kids that need mentorship. That's why I can really relate to the students that, you know, I mentor every day, or the kids from Waco ISD. I can really relate because I come from the same background. Sometimes it's hard. Sometimes it's hard working with students who have no desire to be at school that day. At least, the least I can do is try my best.
But I will come if you need me to, because I want you to succeed, okay?
Yeah.
I want you to do the right thing, make good choices.
What's up? We having a good time, you all right?
Yeah.
All right. Come on in. Thank y'all for being here. Y'all are awesome today.
I think it's important for people to serve. We started an organization called Saving and Successful. We would meet every month for mentorship, doing community events. Something changes in your own heart when you serve others. Giving back changes you. That's my goal, that people would think less of themselves and say, like, who can I invest in this semester? Or who can I serve that could never pay me back? The person that you may never see the growth, you may never see a return, you may never get the credit for, but just how can I serve and how can I make a sacrifice for a child? I started getting requests to talk to kids, getting 911 calls, and people would be like, Officer Brown, can you come talk to my kids? I would go and talk to them, and a lot of times the parents would say, is there any kind of program that they can go so they can learn? When they asked this question, I always wanted to be helpful, and I would just say, you know what, there's not a program for that I know of, but I can create one.
We're gonna show up, and when we show up, God does the rest. Hey! You going to boys group tonight? You going to boys group tonight? Where's she at?
Later on, you know, God just gave me a deep desire to start investing in kids.
We have arrived. Got that? Thanks. You know what I thought about doing too? Having all the mentors take a trip together. That'd be fun. You know, they can ask us for help for anything. That's another thing. Like, this is a safe place for them. Definitely, they're gonna get their needs met here. So, yeah, we are willing to serve and we'll pour out. We'll be able to help, but no problem. I want you to get them running up, because this is what gets me excited. Like, look, there they go. Look, Chris, boys. All right, guys. So, all right, before we go in, we're gonna have fun today.
I let them know that this is not a requirement like school. This is something that you come because you wanna grow. Hey, we're gonna teach them respect. We're gonna teach them love. We're gonna teach them kindness.
Boys group starts today, and we're just gonna start off strong. We wanna get to know you guys. We wanna show you guys how to become better boys.
The boys learn teamwork, we go on trips. And we also allow them to create curriculum. We're like, what do y'all wanna learn?
Anything else, and this is y'all's show, okay? What he's doing right now is he's making the batter. Say batter. Batter. Right. So he's been doing that. And then we're gonna pour a little bit in the waffle maker.
I've seen them start to respect each other a lot more. Start to pay attention a lot more. A lady came up to me and she told me, Dairus, you don't realize that those kids don't fight no more at the bus stop. They used to fight all the time at the bus stop, but since you've been mentoring, they stopped fighting.
check it? You wanna check it?
That 1 hour a week has made such an impact that the whole city may see it. The whole city may benefit from this 1 hour a week that we've invested. If there's more people in Waco investing in kids, we would see a dynamic change in our school district. We would see kids graduating high school just like ready for work or ready for college, ready for Air Force, just making that time out just to invest in one. I feel like when you invest so much in a person, the influence you have on them matters. People looked at me and said, you are least likely to succeed. You will never become anything. My desire is for kids to grow up and just become what they really wanted to do.
And thank you for everybody who cooked, and thank you for all the volunteers. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All I heard was bull, nothing else.